Hello everyone. In the previous video, we talked about overloading the multiplication operator and how we can have it behave differently for different types of inputs, adding robustness and flexibility to our class. While we could extend this to other operators such as division, modulus, and subtraction, here the concept is the same. In this video, we're going to talk about how to go about printing a class using something that's more C++ oriented by using the double angle brackets, as we can see here, that is commented out into the code. So how would I start about implementing this? Well, what's going to go on here is we're going to create a special type of function, not method. This is going to be called a friend function. So we're going to be using the friend keyword, and when we want to overload the double angle bracket operator, it gets a little bit special. So it turns out that the return data type of the double angle brackets, which is here, the return type for this, and actually the return type for standard C out, is called standard OStream. And here what we're going to do is that we're going to get a reference, an operator, double angle brackets. So this is going to take two inputs, another OStream, which I'll call OS for output stream. And here we're going to provide our shape, right? So something to highlight is that this is an independent function. So why is it declared here? Well, because when we are going to use this operator, we have the option of accessing the private data of this shape, which we will need to, because if we're printing it, we want to show the data that's inside of it, mainly the attributes. Although in this example, we're going to be using our getters, this also leaves the option of accessing the private attributes themselves. And here we get an input that's going to be the output stream, which is the same data type as standard C out, and it's also going to return the same data type as C out. And the idea with this is so that way we can have a statement like this. I can say C out, I can say what is it? I can say my shape, I can say my second shape, maybe a string, a number, let's see, 7, another string, and we'll say my third shape, and then standard end line. Right, the idea here is that here we have a lot going on, and how this will go is that this will start from left to right. So we start with this, and then we end up printing out my shape, then we want to print out my second shape. So it's very important that we get this as the input, which will be all the material that's going to be to the left, and this is going to be our new value, and then we're going to return this OStream, the reference to this OStream. And this makes sense because this is going to be all the stuff that's going to be to the left of those specific double angle brackets, we need to return that same OStream just in case we have some junk here, right? I mean, not junk. So that way, just in case we want to keep printing shapes and integers and things like that. So in this case, this standard OStream, and let's highlight this example better. Right here, what's going on is that when I'm talking about this OStream, and this is, let's rename it a shape. Here in this example, when I talk about OStream and shape, this reference to the output stream is going to be everything to the left of shape that's going to be printed, that's already been printed. So in this case, if my third shape here is shape, then all this that's highlighted here can be all of have this. That's the idea. And when we're done adding this to the output stream, we need to return a reference to that O stream, so that way down the line, right, we can shift this and I can have another shape here where when we look at this shape, all this O stream stuff to the left is going to contain all of this that has already been added. Right? And that's the idea with getting an input that's O stream and returning that same output that's O stream, so that we can continue adding things and printing things and printing things, because we never know what's going to be in between of printing shape 2D. It could be another shape 2D, it could be a string, it could be numbers, we never know. And the idea is that we want to create something that is robust. So now that this function has been defined and has access to the private attributes of shape 2D because it's a friend, we're going to go about implementing this in shape 2D. And here is where things get a little bit confusing. Again, because it's a friend, it's not exactly part of the class, but because it's a friend, what we're trying to say is that this function, our Shape2D class can trust this function. Trust it with accessing the private attributes. So because of that, when I define it, I'm going to say standard OStream. Notice I'm not saying friend again. I don't need to say friend again because it's already been declared in the header file. But I'm going to do the operator, double angle bracket. We're going to do the standard OStream again. I'm going to have OS for output stream in our const shape2d shape. Okay, so notice the missing friend. And also notice that I have no shape2d colon colon, right? If this was part of the class, if this was a method, I would have to write shape2d colon colon right here. However, this is an independent function because it's a friend. So we get rid of this and we're totally fine. So how do we go about printing it? Well, when it comes to overloading this operator, you can think of this input, this variable, which is OS, you can kind of think of it as cout. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to say OS, and what I'll do is I'll say shape get length and a space shape get width. And then I'll end this print statement with a space and continue this on the new line. I will say OS is going to be shape, and we're going to calculate the area. Another space. And we're going to calculate the perimeter. Perimeter. And then when we're done with printing what we like to print, I'm just going to return OS. So it turns out that there was an error with using the area method and the perimeter method. And in order to fix that, what I had to do is I had to make the perimeter return, the perimeter body constant, as well as the area constant. And that is because we have this constant shape2d that needs access to the method this way, and it can't get access to these methods if these aren't constant. So I changed this to both be constant and it solved that problem. So now we're able to successfully overload the double angle brackets operator and print it as we would with standard cout. So why don't I test this and this, and let's see what happens. And we can build and run. Actually, I'll exit out of this. Okay. Right, so this makes sense. This is going to be our first square. This is our second square. We print our number 7, and then here we have the third square. So this is able to successfully print the class, and actually you can see the third being printed here. So in addition to this, why don't we also print overloading our other operators? So I'll say shape 2D x 5 and 5. And what I'll do is that I will print x times x, and then I will print a space, I like using the double quotes, and I'll do x times 2, and we'll print an end line. So let's see what happens here. Here it is. So we have 25 and 25. This makes sense because 5 times 5 is 25. We calculate the area. This also makes sense, and the perimeter makes sense. Yep, all these calculations seem good to me. So here we've just finished on overloading the double angle brackets operator. This is quite important. It's a very important operator to overload. This is probably an operator that I myself overload all the time when I create a class. One can define a print function, but it seems a little bit more difficult to use. This feels more streamlined compared to using a print function, because this seems more intuitive on printing values, right? We use this type of methodology in printing integers, floats, strings, etc. So why not extend that to the classes that you create? In the next video, what we'll start covering is object-oriented programming and inheritance. Thank you.